मेहनत करने वालों की हार नहीं होती, चाहे कितनी भी हो मुश्किलें, हर मुश्किल है पार होती। हार्ड वर्क एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग डिटर्मिनेशन हेल्प्स यू नेविगेट थ्रू ऑल द डिफिकल्टीज ऑफ लाइफ, हाउएवर बिग दे मे सीम, एंड हेल्प यू रीच योर गोल्स। हाई एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू डेंटिज़न। टुडे वी आर हियर विद द न्यू वीडियो ऑन द टॉपिक ओडोंटोजेनिक्सिस। थैंक यू ऑल फॉर पोरिंग योर रिक्वेस्ट फॉर द वीडियो टॉपिक्स। So in this video, we are going to discuss introduction and parts of a cyst, definition of a cyst, and classification of cyst. So before we begin, I want you to subscribe to Dentozen if you have not done that till now. Also follow me on Instagram and Facebook for more related content and Viva questions. So in this video, we are going to understand what is a cyst, hota kya hai, what are the parts of a cyst. We'll also understand what is a true cyst and what is a false cyst. Then we'll also understand the definition of cyst, which is very, very important Viva question. Then we'll talk about the classification of cyst, which is an important exam question. So, what is a cyst? A cyst is a cavity. It is an empty space which is surrounded by a solid object. So, it is a space. Now, we have so many normal spaces or normal cavities in the body. Like we have nasal cavity, which is nose, then we have oral cavity, which is mouth. So are these all cysts? No. Why? Because cyst is a unique cavity. It is not normal. It is a pathological cavity. Pathological means it is formed by a disease process, pathology, disease. So it is a pathological cavity. Very, very important point. Now, what is present inside this cavity? What is present inside this space? This space may contain different materials. So, it may be fluid, or it may be semi-fluid, or it may be gas. So, these are called the contents of the cyst. So, pathological cavity having fluid, semi-fluid, or gaseous contents. But it is not created by pus. Not. Very, very important point. It is not created by pus. Now, this cyst is lined by a layer of epithelial cells form the lining of the cyst, which is known as the epithelial lining, which can be of different types in different cysts. So, epithelial lining. Then, the outermost part of the cyst is made up of a wall, which is made up of connective tissue. Now, this wall of the cyst is known as the connective tissue wall of the cyst, also called as capsule of the cyst. So, we have three parts of the cyst. The central part, which is empty space, which is called lumen. This lumen may contain fluid, semi-fluid or gaseous contents. Second part is the epithelial lining, which lines the surface of the cavity. Third part is the connective tissue wall or the capsule on the outermost part of the cyst. Now, this epithelial lining can be present or it may be absent. So, the cysts in which the epithelial lining is present, they are called true cysts. And the cysts in which epithelial lining is absent, they are called false cysts or pseudocysts. So let's quickly revise. The three parts of a cyst are cystic lumen, that is the central cavity, which contains fluid, semi-fluid or gas. Then the cystic epithelial lining, which is made up of epithelial cells, which can be of different types and differences. And the outermost layer, which is cystic wall, also known as capsule, which is made up of connective tissue. So what are true cysts? If the cysts contain epithelium, then they are true cysts. If the cysts do not have epithelium is absent, then they are called false cyst or pseudocyst. Now here you will get your next Viva question, that what are the examples of true cyst and false cyst that we are going to see later in this video. Now we come to the definition of cyst, which is very, very important Viva question. Now your examiner wants to know who gave this definition. This definition was given by Kramer in the year 1974. And in this definition, we have four parts. So we already know cyst is a pathological cavity. What does it contain? Having fluid, semi-fluid or gaseous contents. And what is not present? It is not created by accumulation of pus. Then epithelium may or may not be present. So most cysts but not all are lined by epithelium. Most cysts have epithelium, but not all of them. So you can remember this definition
by dividing it into four parts. Next, we come to the classification of cyst. Now, Shear gave a classification of cyst according to which these cysts, these pathological cavities, may be present in the jaws, which are known as the cysts of the jaws. They may be present in the maxillary sinus or the maxillary antrum, or they may be present in the soft tissues of the mouth, face, neck, and salivary glands. Now, out of these three categories, the most important for us are the cysts of jaws, which we are going to discuss. So, cysts of the jaws can be lined by epithelium, or they can be non-epithelial line, which are called pseudocysts. So, cysts of the jaws can be classified as epithelial cyst or non-epithelial line cyst. Now, epithelial line can further be divided according to developmental origin or inflammatory origin. Now, these developmental cysts can further be classified based on the origin. If the epithelium of the cyst is coming from odontogenic tissue, odonto means tooth. Genic means forming. So those tissues, those epithelial cells which normally form the tooth, those tissues, if they form the lining, epithelial lining of the cyst, those cysts are known as odontogenic cysts. And if the epithelial lining of a cyst comes from some other source, those are called non-odontogenic cysts. Now let's see the examples. So cysts of the jaws can be epithelial line cysts, non-epithelial line cysts. Epithelial line cysts are further classified into developmental origin and inflammatory origin. Developmental origin can be odontogenic or non-odontogenic. Or the examples of odontogenic are gingival cyst of infants and gingival cyst of adults, odontogenic keratocyst, dentigerous cyst and eruption cyst, lateral periodontal cyst and botryoid odontogenic cyst, glandular odontogenic cyst and calcifying odontogenic cyst. Don't get scared by the name. Once you will learn these cysts, it will become easier. So non-odontogenic can be mid-palatine raphe of the cyst of infants, nasopalatine duct cyst, nasolabial cyst. So in these cysts, the epithelial lining comes from some other source, from the non-odontogenic source. Then inflammatory origin cysts are radicular cyst, very, very important, residual cyst, periodontal cyst, inflammatory collateral cyst. Then examples of non-epithelial line cyst or pseudocyst are solitary bone cyst, aneurysmal bone cyst. Very, very important viva question. Examples of pseudocyst or false cyst. Now let's understand odontogenic cyst. Odonto tooth genic forming. Or we have already read in our first year in dental histology subject that the tooth forming tissues like ectoderm. Ectoderm forms the dental lamina, which forms the enamel organ, which is initially of bud shape, which later turns into a cap-shaped structure, and which later turns into a bell-shaped structure. So these are the odontogenic tissues which give rise to this. These tissues later will form a layer downwards, which is known as HERS, Herdwig's epithelial root sheath, which will give rise to root. So we have odontogenic tissues, dental lamina, enamel organ, and Herdwig's epithelial root sheath, which give rise to different parts of a tooth. Now, once the tooth formation is complete and tooth is still in the jaws, dental lamina will break down. It will form cell rest of serrae, the remnants of dental lamina, which are in the resting phase. These epithelial cell rest group of cells, it is present in the gingiva and in the jaws. And enamel organ will get compressed and it will form reduced enamel epithelium over the crown of the tooth, like this, as you can see here. And the HERS will also break down. The remnants of HERS, the epithelial cell rest, are known as cell rest of malacy. So we have three sources, that is cell rest of serrae, which are remnants of dental lamina, reduced enamel epithelium, and cell rest of malacy, which are remnants of HERS. So these three sources can give rise to the epithelium of the cyst. Epithelial lining of the cyst may be derived from any of these three sources, and those cysts are called odontogenic cysts. So we see odontogenic cysts are true cysts because they have epithelial lining. Where are they present? They are present in the jaws, because these odontogenic tissues are present in the jaws. So when do they start forming cysts? These epithelial cells, which are present in the jaws, when they get stimulated by some source, they start to proliferate, they form a hollow cavity, and they form the lining of this cavity, and then it is known as odontogenic cyst. Now let's come to the classification of odontogenic cyst, which is usually asked in exam. So classification of odontogenic cyst is based on two things. First classification is based on etiology, that is cause. Second is classification based on the tissue of origin, that means where the epithelium is coming from. So let's see this one by one. Classification by etiology, they can be developmental cysts when the origin is unknown, and they can be inflammatory cysts when the origin is result of inflammation. So classification by etiology, they can be developmental or inflammatory. Now, examples of developmental are dentigerous cyst, eruption cyst, odontogenic keratosis, gingival cyst of newborn, gingival cyst of adults, lateral periodontal cyst, calcifying odontogenic cyst, and glandular odontogenic cyst. And those which are inflammatory, examples are periapical cyst, residual cyst, and periodontal cyst. Now, let's see the second classification. That is based on the tissue of origin. So we have already seen the different odontogenic tissues which can give rise to odontogenic cysts. They can be cell rest of malassez, which are remnants of HERS, or reduced enamel epithelium, or cell rest of cerebellum, which are the remnants of dentalamina. Let's see the examples of each one of these. So from the cell rest of malassez, we have periapical cyst and residual cyst. From epithelial lining derived from reduced enamel epithelium are dentigerous cyst and eruption cyst. And odontogenic cysts, which in which the epithelium is derived from cell rests of cerebellum, are odontogenic keratosis, gingival cyst of newborn, gingival cyst of adult, and lateral periodontal cyst and glandular odontogenic cyst. So these two are the important classifications of odontogenic cysts. That is, first based on the etiology, second based on the tissue of origin. Now, you may sometimes be asked about the WHO 2017 classification of odontogenic cysts. So in 2017, WHO gave a classification of odontogenic cysts. Based on the origin, they can be developmental origin or inflammatory origin. So in developmental origin, they can be dentigerous cyst, odontogenic keratosis, lateral periodontal and botryoid odontogenic cyst, gingival cyst, glandular odontogenic cyst and calcifying odontogenic cyst, and orthokeratinized odontogenic cyst. Whereas in inflammatory origin, we have radicular cyst and collateral inflammatory cyst. So in this video, we discussed what is a cyst, what are the different parts of a cyst. So a cyst has three parts, that is central lumen, epithelial lining, and the connective tissue wall, which is also known as capsule of the cyst. Then we discussed what is a true cyst. When epithelium is present, then it is called a true cyst. When epithelium is not present or absent, it is called a false cyst or a pseudocyst. Then we discussed the definition of cyst. So definition of cyst was given by Kramer in 1974, and this definition has four parts. That is, cyst is a pathological cavity. It contains fluid, semi-fluid or gaseous content. It is not formed by pus, and epithelial lining may or may not be present. So those are the four parts. Then we discuss the classification of odontogenic cysts. Odontogenic cysts can be classified based on the etiology and based on the origin. So based on etiology, they can be developmental or inflammatory. Based on origin, the epithelial lining may be derived from cell rest of malassez, may be derived from reduced enamel epithelium, or may be derived from cell rest of cerebellum. So that is all for this video. If you understood the video, if you really like the video, do tap on the like button and keep following DentoZen. Good luck for your exams. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.